First time installing a GE product? I'm Kathleen McKenna. I'm an information developer here at GE Digital, and I'm going to walk you through the process. A few important things before we get started. So iFIX is supported on several Windows operating systems, but for purposes of this video, we'll be installing a standalone iFIX SCADA node on Windows Server 2016. For a complete list of all the supported operating systems, just Google iFIX software requirements and you get the latest list from our ebooks. Before you begin the installation process, you need to do a few things. First, log into your computer as an administrator, confirm you aren't logged in via an RDP or terminal service session, and then make sure that there are no other GE processes running. There are four steps to install iFIX. Step one is to run the product install. Step two, after installing, get the latest updates from the support website. Step three, for security purposes, change the default usernames and passwords for iFIX. And then step four, optionally, update the host file if you're required to do so. Now let's get started. Step one, run the product install. Click the iFIX 5.9 link from the install splash screen, right here. If you haven't installed the latest Microsoft Visual Studio redistributables, this action runs automatically. A message box appears, a terminal server remote admin is also detected. And just click OK to continue. A welcome screen will appear, next the license agreement. Accept the terms to continue. Next, you're going to select the type of iFIX install. I'm going to select complete just because I want to show what happens when you install everything. But most of the time, you're just going to select typical. Click next and leave the default path. Right here, and you'll see several screens will appear as the install progresses. If you have never installed a GE product before, the common licensing will install first. Then the base product will start to install. So just hang out here for a little bit. Now you can see near the end of the install, there'll be some additional options that will install, such as the .NET component, which will be right about here. And now you'll see, getting close to the end here, here we go. In the next dialog that appears, I'm going to select Standalone and SCADA. Click Yes to allow iFIX through the firewall. Since iFIX allows scripting in Visual Basic, there's a couple of Microsoft updates that also need to get updated. Then you could choose to read the release notes and reboot your computer. Now for step two, after you restart your computer, you want to go to the support website and download the latest updates. So log into digitalsupport.ge.com, go to the iFIX 5.9 product download page right here, and you'll see at this point in time there are no service packs or relevant SIMs that we need to get. So I'll scroll down here. You know, but it's always good to check. So for step three, for security purposes, it's really important for you to go in and change those default usernames and passwords that come shipped with iFIX. So in order to do so, you need to start iFIX. It's okay if it's in demo mode. Open the workspace, click the application tab, and then click security configuration utility. Click OK, as this is what we're going to fix. Next, click the users button, the first one in the toolbar, click the guest user, and then modify it. This opens the user profile dialog box. You want to change the default username and password, and then click OK. Next, click the system administrator, modify, and then do the same thing. Click OK to finish, and then save and exit the app. Now, as your fourth and final step, if iFIX is not on a domain, you probably need to update the Windows host file. This isn't a step that everybody has to do. It really depends upon your setup. This file assists Windows in resolving host names with their IP addresses. So from Windows Explorer, you can find the host file in the Windows System 32 drivers etc folder. Edit this file in a text editor like Notepad. All you need to do is add the IP address and the computer name here, like this. Here we go. And then we're going to just save the file. This concludes our install walkthrough. Thank you again for watching.